टुडे राजराजेश्वरी ब्रह्मोत्सव सेवेंथ डे देवी इज ग्रेसिंग ऑन सिद्धपीठ कैलास कैलास इन विच ऑल द सिद्धास आर सिटिंग देवी इज ग्रेसिंग विच श्रीदेवी एंड भूदेवी लक्ष्मी एंड सरस्वती ऑन कैलास When I see the Vakyartha Sadas, hear the Vakyartha Sadas by Balasans of Nityananda Gurukul, I really feel I have already produced the disciples Ramanuja had and like the disciples Buddha had. When I am listening to Vakyartha Sadas, I know I have not spoken unnecessarily. Are all my words have not become waste. My Gurukul kids bio memories are holding it. If somebody can experientially understand the truths to manage the life, he can understand anything. Anything, I tell you. They just became a living example of awakened third eye. Now, I am refining the meditation techniques and taking them to the next level of third eye awakening, where not only they can read whatever is in the mind of the people or blindfold reading and all these things, they will also see the reality beyond what is seen as a world. They will see this world as a dream and see the reality beyond this world. I can see when my kids are declaring, speaking the truth about death, conscious birth, kshana, all that. It is reality for them. Understand. It is not that they just repeat like a parrot whatever they heard from me. It has become reality. That is why they are able to repeat so properly. And so much of courage and confidence is in their eyes. It is lifestyle for them. If you have a kid, the best thing you can do for the kid is put him or her in Gurukul. And rest in peace. Come to Varanasi to experience third eye awakening if you missed Gurukul when you were young. This coming Varanasi inner awakening, I am going to initiate everyone into this third eye awakening and blindfold reading. If the third eye can be awakened fully, not only you will make whatever you dream as reality, you will also realize whatever is your reality itself is one more dream. May inner awakening in Varanasi. Please understand, actually the meaning of the word Varanasi means the space between eyebrows and nose. Varana Nas in Sanskrit. Varana means the space between the eyebrows, and Nasi means nose. The space between eyebrows and the nose, third eye. So Varanasi is the space of third eye. In the space of third eye, awakening your third eye. Come to Varanasi to experience third eye awakening this May.
Tripura Sundari Ha. Hyderabad Adinam celebrated the Lakshya Pushparchana on the occasion of Rajarajeshwari Brahmotsavam at the Nityanandeshwari Temple, Hyderabad. Non-stop Shivoham chanting started from 11 a.m. to conclude at 9:30 p.m.
See, your mind can never perceive consciousness. So when you move from this dream and when you go to reality, still in that, your mind can understand what is that in the reality. So it is only consciousness. So even when you go there, you'll come, after reaching there, you will come to know that it is, that this is also a dream. Only consciousness is not the dream. This is also a dream. You will feel that, and then by that you will come to know reality is a dream.
Reality can lead us to consciousness, because I don't feel that it is not consciousness. I feel that it can lead us to consciousness.
I have a question. But in one satsang, Swamiji told the level of truth is enlightenment and the level of reality is living Advaita. Does that mean that living Advaita is not consciousness?
Living Advaita is basically, in English it is called as oneness. And oneness is just a quality of consciousness. So therefore, you being in living Advaita will lead you to consciousness. Living Advaita itself is not consciousness. It will lead you to consciousness.
And also what I feel is, Swamiji told that consciousness, the moment you can perceive something, it is not consciousness. It's just a form of consciousness. So the moment you think Shiva is ultimate, you add few qualities to Shiva. So that itself is not the ultimate. That itself is not consciousness. It is only a form of consciousness.
But how can a form of consciousness not be consciousness itself?
Consciousness is filled everywhere, so you can avoid just putting the consciousness into one particular form. It is like you have the whole ocean, and you can avoid just filling the whole ocean into the water bottle, in a small water bottle. It's like that. So consciousness can avoid being just a form. It is filled everywhere.
When a person who is just in the space of perception, when he is looking at the world from his view, it is like he is having a mind through which he perceives, and he is not going to get much picture about it. He is just going to see some plants and things like that. When he moves on to the, suppose he is seeing it from the first floor, then it's like that. When he moves on to the fifth floor, just keep it as fact, then he'll be able to see things which is beyond just trees. And he might be able to see a few more buildings, few people walking around the streets. So there his mind changes. Then when he moves even more into the truth, there maybe it's seventh floor or eighth floor. There he is able to see much more than what he was able to see when he was in the level of fact. When he is in reality itself, then he'll be able to see the whole thing, and his big picture is gained. So what I feel is, mind itself is the source. It is just moving from one space to the next space. Our perception is just evolving, so it is still the source.
But I have a question about what you said. See, in the example you gave, whichever floor you go to, you're only seeing, so you're only perceiving. So even in the topmost floor, which what you said is reality, you're still perceiving, right? So that is perception, reality.
What I think is, the fact that you're perceiving is the same in all the things. But what you perceive is different in each and everything. What you perceive at the first floor is different from what you perceive at the fifth floor. And what you perceive at the fifth floor will be different from what you perceive at the tenth floor. So for you, perceiving is the same in all the floors, but what you perceive is what is different.
Actually, I was a brahmachari in the Ramakrishna Mission for 9 years. When I was in the Ramakrishna Mission in Chennai in 1995, I had the opportunity to stay with the Swami Nityananda Paramahamsa. Each and every monks was attracted by him. Those who are coming from the our ashrama itself, from the outside also, very much impressed by him. And he used to talk about the Turiya levels are very high level. So he used to tell about the Turiya, etc. Actually, he will talk only about this type of spirituality only. Whenever the lecture time in night class or wherever the extra time is there, we will ask him to deliver the lecture without any fear. Now, how you are seeing about his bhava, he is laughing. or his whatever his style. Well, that time, at the time itself, it was there. So we used to always crack a joke with him. You will become a very big person after that. There will be a so much gathering of the people like that. Or all we used to laugh and cut jokes with him. And actually, we thought that he will be a very big sannyasin. But this Avadara Purusha's qualities, that time itself, he shown his about the Avadara life, and he explained about his spiritualities to some of our devotees and some of our monks itself.
Guru Nada Nityananda.